Good morning, praise the Lord. Today, October 22nd, we'll talk about the 10th book in the New Testament. This is the Paul's letter to Ephesians. Ephesians, mainly it's about the building the body of Christ is the key word in this book. Ephesians 2:10 says, "We are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand." Ephesians is addressed to a group of believers who are indescribably rich in Jesus Christ, but living a beggarly existence because they are ignorant of their wealth. And because they have not appropriated their wealth, they are walking like they are spiritual paupers. Paul begins by describing in chapter 1 to 3 every spiritual blessing. Drawing upon that huge spiritual endowment, the Christian has all the resources he needs to live to the praise of the glory of his grace. Chapters 4 to 6 resemble an orthopedic clinic where the Christians learn a spiritual walk rooted in his spiritual wealth. The theme of Ephesians is the believer's responsibility to walk in accordance with his heavenly calling in Christ Jesus. Ephesians was not written to correct specific errors in a local church, but to prevent problems in the church as a whole by encouraging the body of Christ to mature in him. Paul wanted the believers to know their position in Christ. This book unveils the mystery of the church as no other epistle does. God's secret intention is revealed. His focuses are, I'll give you 3 points about that. To form a body to express Christ's fullness on Jesus, on earth. Second is to do this by uniting both Jews and Gentiles who believe. Third is to equip, empower, and mature this group to the end. Ephesians is called the Alps of the New Testament, the Grand Canyon of Scripture, and the Royal Capstone of the Epistles. Nice titles. Alps of the New Testament, the Grand Canyon of Scripture, the Royal Capstone of the Epistles. Not only because of its grand theme, but because of the majesty of Christ revealed here. Christ is revealed in different portions, revealed in different manner. The following I'll reveal it to you. First is, he is the Redeemer, first chapter. Second is, he is the peacemaker who has reconciled man to God. Just keep these points in mind. The pictures of Christ, how he is picturized in this book. First is Redeemer, second is peacemaker. Third is, he is the treasure in whom life's unsearchable riches are found. Fourth is, he is the giver of ministry gifts to his church. Fifth, he is the model husband, selflessly loving his bride, which is the church. Sixth is, he is the Lord, mighty in battle, the resource of strength. Let's pray. Lord, thank you, Lord, for doing all this for us and being a constant advisor for us. Please help us to learn the greatness. In Jesus' precious name I ask. Amen. Amen. God bless you.